Good morning, students. Myself, C.C. Saurav, teacher in USCD DAV Public School, Maharajganj. Welcome to the second part of the video lecture on the topic Chemical Reactions and Equations. In this lecture, we are going to discuss how to balance the chemical equation. So let us go to method. So the method behind balancing the chemical equation is known as stepwise balancing method. And this method is very often commonly known as heat and trial method. So this method basically deals with six steps. In step number one, what you will do is you have to write whatever the reaction you are supposed to be balanced. Now coming on to the step number two, here what you need to do is you have to count the number of elements present on the both sides of the chemical equation. As you know that there are two sides of the equation. One is reactant side, another is product side. So you have to count the number of atoms of every element, whatever present on the each side of the chemical equation. Now we are moving on to the third step. In the third step, what we need is we have to add certain numerical numbers in order to make them equal. So in third step, you have to take into account that whatever the element which is present in the highest number, they have to be balanced first. Then you have to move on to the fourth step. In the fourth step, what we need is you have to balance all the rest of the atoms of the element by adding suitable coefficient in the terms of numerals. Okay. Now, after fourth step, the reaction is almost balanced, but still it is not considered as a balanced equation. So we'll move on to the fifth step. In fifth step, what we need is you have to mention in which state the reactants and products are. Sometimes the reactants are in solid state and products are in gaseous state. So you have to mention these, that these are the certain states and product is in gaseous state. As accordingly, we have to see the physical state. Now, last and not the least, the necessary condition like temperature, pressure and catalyst, they have to be mentioned during the chemical equation. What happened? Most of the time, we used to ignore this thing. But actually, the balanced equation is only applicable if each and everything should be in a proper order. If in any equation you find that the sixth one is missing, that means it is assumed that the reaction is going under room temperature and room temperature and atmospheric pressure. So no heat is required. Now let us know this by taking a now let us take the example of iron react with water to form ferric ferrous oxide and hydrogen gas. So in step number one, we'll keep the reaction as it is. In step number two, what we'll do is we have to count the number of atoms present on the reactant side and the number of atoms present on the product side. As you can easily see here, iron contain one atom, hydrogen contain two atoms and oxygen contain one atom in the reactant side. And in case of product side, iron contain three atoms, oxygen contain four atoms and hydrogen contain two atoms. So which atom is having present in highest number? Oxygen. So in step number three, we will first balance oxygen atom. So in order to balance the oxygen atom, we will add four in place of in front of water molecule. So now the oxygen is balanced. Now we will move on to the fourth step. In this step, we will going to balance all the rest of the element. So how many elements are remaining? Iron and hydrogen. So for balancing the next element, we have to see the order. After four, what will come? Three. So we'll first balance iron. So iron three. Now again right hand side also three. Okay, balanced. Now coming on to the hydrogen atom, if you will find that in case of hydrogen in reactant side, it is 4 into 2, 8 hydrogen atom, but in case of product side, it is only two. So what we'll do is we'll add before hydrogen four. So now everything is balanced. Now still one thing is unbalanced, that is your state. So as you know that iron is in solid state, so write in place of iron a small bracket and write S. Then again what we are doing is we are taking gaseous form of water here. So in place of water you will add gas. Ferric sulfide is a solid, so right here solid. Now hydrogen is a gas, so right here in a small bracket gas, which is already indicated below. Now this reaction, this method may be applicable for those reactions which are very simpler. But take the example of those reactions which are very complicated. So in order to balance those reactions, we have to write several atoms. So let us see how there are other methods by which we can balance chemical equation containing large number of atoms, and the method used here is alternate method. So let us see. In this method, we'll balance the chemical equation in 6 steps. First step comprises of writing the chemical equation. Whatever the chemical reaction is given to you, you will write as it is. In second step, what you will do is we'll count the number of atoms alias group of atoms. But then what comprises group of atoms? Group of atoms means where the group contain more than 2 atoms. Take the example of sulfate, phosphate, nitrate, carbonate. These all the groups contain more than 2 or 3 atoms. Okay, so these are counted as a single entity during calculation. Now in step 3, we'll equalize all the atoms of the element or group of atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. So while calculating, we have to take into account that hydrogen, oxygen, they have to be balanced later on, and before whatever elements or whatever the groups are coming, they have to be balanced first. In doing so, we have to take into account that if the metal atom is there, they have to be balanced first, followed by non-metal. Now in step 4, we will balance first oxygen atom, then we'll move on to the hydrogen atom. In most of the cases, you'll find that whenever oxygen atom is balanced, hydrogen will be automatically balanced. Now we'll write or mention the physical state of the chemical reaction containing reactants and products. Okay, so basically there are 3 states: solid, liquid, gas, and one more is there, that is aqueous state. Okay. Now in step number 6, we'll write the necessary condition like temperature, pressure and catalyst that should be written above and below the arrow. Now let us take a suitable example to prove this method. In this example, we have taken the example between aluminium oxide react with HCl to form aluminium chloride and water. In reactant side, you will see that aluminium contain 2 atoms. Chlorine contain 1 atom, oxygen contain 3 atoms, and hydrogen contain 1 atom. In product side, we have oxygen 1 atom, chlorine 3 atoms, aluminium 1 atom, and hydrogen 2 atoms. So as you already know that here, which is balanced first? First, what we need to do, we have to balance the metal atom. So in order to balance the metal atom, I have written 2 in before aluminium chloride. So now the metal atom is balanced. So again, what is unbalanced? Now we have unmetal, non-metal atom, that is chlorine, is unbalanced. In aluminium chloride, 1 molecule contain 3 chlorine atoms. So 2 molecule contain how many? 6 chlorine atoms. But in reactant side, it is only written 1. So in order to make it equal, we have to place 6 in before HCl. Now we know that aluminium and chlorine is balanced. Now still we have 2 unbalanced molecule, that is atoms, that is oxygen and hydrogen. So in we will move on to the 4th step, that in this step we'll try to balance oxygen. So in reactant side, how many oxygen is there? 3. So in before water molecule, we'll write here 3. Now the oxygen is balanced. Now still, now which is unbalanced? In reactant side, you will see that hydrogen is 6, in product side also 6. So hydrogen is automatically balanced. As I have told you earlier that when you are going to balance the oxygen atom, automatically the hydrogen atom will be balanced. Now we'll move on to the 5th step. Here we'll mention the physical state of the reactants and products. Aluminium oxide is a solid, so as HCl, it is dissolved in water, so aqueous state. Now aluminium chloride, again it is dissolved in water, so aqueous state, and water, as you know that it's a physical state, is liquid, so L. Now let us take another example. In this example, I have taken a group of atoms. Now calcium hydroxide react with phosphoric acid, it will form calcium phosphate plus water. Here what we need is we have to take element as well as group. So calcium, I have taken 1 element. In second, I have taken phosphate group, not as a phosphorus and oxygen, but phosphate group. Then we have oxygen, then we have hydrogen. Now reactant side, how many calcium atom? 1. In product side, how many calcium atom? 3. Phosphate, you can see phosphate in reactant side, how many? 1. In phosphate in product side, it is 2. Oxygen 2, oxygen in reactant side it is 2 and product side it is 1. In hydrogen, in reactant side it is 5 and product side it is 2. So here you will find that calcium and phosphate both are unbalanced. So what, which will be balanced first? The first balance will be calcium. So in the third step, what I did is I have balanced the calcium by putting 3 in place of in before calcium hydroxide. Now the calcium is balanced. Now again we'll see how many phosphate atom on the product side, phosphate group on the product side, 2. So again I have put 2 in before phosphoric acid. Now 2 phosphate groups, so this is also balanced. Now still which is unbalanced? Oxygen and hydrogen. So we'll move on to the fourth step. Here we will balance, try to balance oxygen and hydrogen. So as you know that first which is to be balanced? Oxygen. So in order to balance the oxygen, I have written here 6H2O. So how many oxygen? 6. Again, you have to count in the reactant side. Here 3 into 2, 6. So oxygen also 6. Balanced. Now if you are trying to see hydrogen, hydrogen is already balanced. So this is a balanced chemical equation. Still, we have to mention the physical state of the chemical reaction. Calcium hydroxide is present in aqueous state. Phosphoric acid, it is acid, so it is also present in aqueous state. Calcium phosphate, aqueous state, and water present in liquid state. Now here are some certain example I have given for you as a homework. Please do it. Thank you.